Hey folks, René Molenaar here for GNS 3 Vault, and I want to show you how you can solve the EIGRP Authentication Rotating Key Lab. So what we have are just two routers running EIGRP, and the idea is that we are going to enable authentication. And if you use authentication for EIGRP, you need to set up a keychain with one or multiple keys, and each key can have an accept and a send lifetime. Now in this lab, what I want to do is make sure that we use key 1 until a certain time, and then we switch over to another key. Okay, so let's start by setting up the keychain, a different password for each key. And key 1 should be sent until 9 a.m. the 2nd of February 2020. Be accepted 15 minutes past this time. And key 2 should be valid 10 to 9, 2nd on February, and valid till about a year later. And the goal of this lab is to make sure that once the keys are switched, that the routing adjacency does not drop. Now, let me show you how to do this. And the first thing I'm going to do is set the clock. So if you do this on a real network, it's better to use NTP. But for this lab, we're just going to use the clock set command. Let's set up the key that we have. So let's start with the keychain. Accept lifetime. I don't care much about the accept lifetime for key 1. We are only concerned about the expiration date. So it's gonna last till 9:15. And the send lifetime is going to be until 9 o'clock February the 2nd, 2020. So that's the first key. Key number 2, key string, another password, accept lifetime 15 minutes to 9. The 2nd of February 2020, and it's valid about 1 year later. Send lifetime here we go. Now let's enable authentication, IP authentication mode, EIGRP authentication number, autonomous system number, MD5, refer to the keychain for EIGRP AS12, and the keychain was called GNS 3 Vault. Now let's copy the whole thing and paste it on the other router here. There we go. And the same thing for the interface commands. Here we go. So our adjacency is up. Now let's start a debug here. Debug EIGRP packets. Now what I want you to show you here is the key ID is number 1, and you can see receive packet with MD5 authentication and so on. So authentication is running now, but it should switch at 9 a.m. So what we are going to do is that I'm going to change the time so you can see that the key will switch. So let's type in the clock command here. Let me increase the fonts a little bit. Clock set. I'm going to set it to 1 minute before 9 to February 2020. And if we do this, then in a minute the key should change. So let's do it on this router. Same thing for this one. So now it's 1 minute to 9. And now pay attention to the key ID. And if everything is okay, it should switch to the other key without dropping the adjacency. Now, I can't imagine that somebody would like to do this on a live network, because if you ask me, it's kind of a pain to set up the whole keychain and the accept and the send lifetime and so on. But so we are still at key 1. There we go. So do you see it? Key ID number 2. So now we have switched over to key number 2. And as you can see, the adjacency did not drop. Let's turn off the debug. And you can see that it's past 9 now. Okay, so that's it. This is how you can configure a rotating key for EIGRP. The whole keychain thing, it's not just for EIGRP. You can do the same thing with RIP if you like. Okay, good. Thanks for watching, and till next time.